On the contracting side, we are working with customers in, as usual, in deferring their some of their commitments. If they don't get paid on time and there is a delay, normal payment cycle is 90 days, and if now it's getting stretched because the project owner is delaying payments, then we have to correspondingly help them by supporting the and extending their terms, which we are proactively supporting and working there. The second impact is a lesser amount of contract means their business capability and turnover will come down. Their revenue is going to come down. They have to go on working on more and more contracts and keep it running to maintain the workforce. So on a longer term, there is an impact. Their order book is shrinking. Then they will have to look at cost reductions. And similar to what happened in 2008-09, these two sectors were severely impacted. And there was a situation where employees were, labor force was sent back on 3 months, 6 months holidays. And then when the market picked up, they were called back to, you know, revive the work. So that kind of actions proactively has to be done. The good thing in the current crisis is all have learned from the 2008-09 crisis to manage the crisis better. Their business continuity plans are more robust nowadays. And banks and customers have the ability to now, who have learned from the lessons in the past, both 2008-09 crisis and the 2015 low oil price crisis, both are better prepared to manage it together. That's what we are trying to do.